Hi. Yeah, good evening. Welcome to WordCamp Mumbai again. This must have been a long break, right? After lunch. This is like almost what, 5:20. All of us want to go home. So I'll try to finish it before I can. Oh, lovely. And the gods are suddenly happy with us. Yeah, it's okay. Just click on this. While we do that, first of all, before I talk about what I'm going to talk about, I need to tell you why am I talking about it and what gives me the right to talk about it, right? Abhi koi expert aake bol raha hai ki yaar main ye karo, wo karo. You should know why is he saying that. There has to be some reason, ability or some special status or something like that, some education or something that allows me, gives me the right to stand in front of you and tell you something, right? So the thing I'm going to talk about is, that's okay, let the keyboard be. Oh, my browser shut down? Is it? Yeah. You got you there, you're almost there. It's on? Yeah. So, some of you know me, some of you don't. I've been working in this industry, the WordPress industry, for a little more than 7 years now. I started off as a person who was interested in WordPress for various reasons. I started working with WordPress. Through WordPress, I mean, I would like to give WordPress that credit. How to reduce the volume of this a little bit? That's a little too loud. Is it too loud? Or is it just me? Okay. So, when I started, I didn't know anything. I didn't know any programming. I am not a programmer background. I am not an engineer. Nothing I've done. So, as far as programming is concerned, it's just my 12th standard mathematics. That's the last thing I did. So WordPress, through WordPress I learned, I figured out, okay, this is called HTML, what do you do with HTML? I learned that, then I learned CSS, then I learned JS, and then that was not enough, so I learned PHP. That was not enough, so I had to learn a few more things. I kept learning till I could proudly say, yeah, I'm a WordPress developer. And then I could say, yes, I'm a programmer as well, because I started programming. Now, because of that, because of my learning, thankfully, because there's so much in the WordPress ecosystem that will help you learn. I mean, that's a good example. Even if you have no programming background, you can actually become a full-fledged programmer just by reading those nice blog posts by all those nice people who wrote it for me. I feel that they wrote it for me. So basically, I learned WordPress, I became a full-fledged developer, and immediately I wanted the iPhone because, you know, someone's saying in the morning, suddenly interested in the iPhone. So looking for the iPhone and yeah, it started partly because of the iPhone, partly because of other things. And it just looks like, you know, that is, can you have this lights a little dimmer or switch it off? Or maybe I can, yeah, thank you. You know, the first thought when you think, when a person leaves a company, when we feel like an employee is leaving an organization, the first thought that comes to your head is they usually do it for money because people are not paying them very well or something like that. So when I went looking for the iPhone and other things, I landed up multiple places. I trialed an automatic, I think, twice for different reasons. I worked with Skyverge. I worked with WPMU Dev. I interviewed at 10UP. So I worked with Articam for a couple of years. I have freelanced extensively. I have 2 failed startups behind me. A lot of things I've done during that time. And I usually failed. Like usually I failed at all these trials and things like that. And it made me wonder, why am I failing? And generally I was unhappy. So it made me wonder, why am I unhappy? That led me to a question, what makes people happy? Like what can I do that will make me happy? That also led to a discovery that I suffer from clinical depression. So that, and I've been suffering from that for like a couple of, at least a decade, I guess, since I was 12 or 13. So I recently discovered that and suddenly it opened my eyes. Suddenly a lot of things made sense. And then my quest continued. I wanted to be happy. So I was looking at the reasons why these jobs didn't work out, or I left companies. I was not satisfied. I wanted a better job, which never meant money to me. For some reason, I don't understand money very well. Like, that shows, right? Even if I have it, I don't know how to use it. So yeah. So the first thought, like, for example, today Sam was giving a talk, and there was a slide that said automatic is hiring, and it said US level salaries. So just to give you a perspective, a lot of companies from US and Europe are hiring from India. Why? No, they give the same salaries. There is no less salary. I used to get paid as much as a developer in US was getting paid. Again, like, yeah, that is one thing, because we are like a second largest population in the world. We'll obviously have more number of things than anybody else. It's just ratios. Standard of living. No, we are happy with those salaries, actually. We are way more, like, we are way happier than with those salaries than maybe an American would be. I'm not sure. Like, I don't know, $25 an hour is, like, you can be rich. Seriously rich. Darshan is laughing, I can see him laughing. And fortunately, I have friends. I have, like, my roommates, ex-roommates. One of them is in 10UP, one of them is in WPMU Dev. Another guy runs his own business. There are many more friends of mine who work in multiple companies. So I come back with all that knowledge, all that perspective, all that big picture. Somebody's talking about the bigger picture. Huh? Bryce was talking about the bigger picture. I got this huge ass big picture. I could see it from the sky. Okay, this is how Earth feels like. So I really got an idea. So this is why people are unhappy. And this is why people leave jobs. This is why people switch from company to company. This is why people especially leave Indian companies and go and work for organizations that hire remotely. To understand that, to get to the perspective that I have, Shilpa said in the morning, like, treat people like people and talk to people as if they are people. It sounds very weird. What are you saying? Talk to people as if they're people. Obviously they're people. Right? All of us are people. But what goes wrong with that sometimes is we quickly forget that people who are working for us or people we are working for are actually people. You know, there is the name of the company, this thing. Like, for example, I have a blog that's called Hook, Refine and Tinker. It doesn't actually mean anything without me or without other people who work for it. So that's a very basic thing that we keep forgetting, that these are people that we're dealing with, and they have the same people needs. They still have to get up in the morning, go to the loo, take a bath before they get out of the house. Some people don't, but yeah, most people do. So these things are common between us. All of us get hungry, all of us get thirsty, and believe me, this is not a problem that I'm the first person to solve, or I've suddenly come up with this huge ass discoveries and inventions that's gonna change everybody's life here. No, these are like at least 100 years old or something. So there's a scientist called Maslow who's very interested in, you know, what makes people happy or what gets them motivated. What do people want? What makes them do stuff? What makes them get out of bed and, you know, take on the world and do stuff, make stuff, etc. So he made this hierarchy of needs. Okay. So he arranged our needs in a level by level structure. This is the most basic need. For example, physiological needs. These are needs like, you know, thirst, hunger, sleep, etc. So everybody has it, even Chipkalis have it, right? Inside us, there is a Chipkali. All of us are basically Chipkalis. If you believe in evolution, we are all lizards inside. Our autonomic nervous system is the same as a lizard's. Above that come the safety needs. As in, all of us don't want to die, right? When it rains, we want a shelter on our head. We want protection from rain, etc. And not just for ourselves, for our family as well, right? So a lot of people come looking for jobs to slightly bigger cities like Mumbai and Pune, from slightly smaller cities or places like Satara and Nashik and Solapur, etc. A lot of people do that. A lot of people come to Mumbai from all over India in chasing their dreams of becoming, you know, getting a fat ass salaried job, having a standard Wagoner or some car like that, a 2 BHK somewhere in Mumbai. That's the basic need. And then comes love and belonging. So he said that after your physiological needs are satisfied, you don't have to worry about whether you'll get food or not, whether you'll get water or not. You don't have to worry about whether you'll have a shelter above your head. You won't have to worry about whether somebody will shoot you on the road. So if there's a war, everything changes. There's no war. We're pretty much satisfied. So when Karthik was talking about millennials today, you know, they don't need these things. They're not worried about this because we already have it. We have friend circles. We have. But compared to somebody who comes from a small town to a big town, doesn't know a lot of people, that may not, you know, probably get satisfied to an extent. Then come needs of self-esteem that we talked about plenty, so I don't have to go into it. People want to do challenging stuff. People want to feel important, confident, proud of what they're doing. People should feel like, you know, somebody in psychology, if you read, there's a chapter about work. The first thing they say is work is a natural state of man. I was like it didn't make sense to me the first time I read. Work is a natural state of man. I thought natural state of man was chair pe sar piche rakhe, taang upar karke. That's how, like, said, that is the natural state of man then. Who likes working? How many people like working every day then? Every day. Sorry, before you caught me. But we want to do that, right? We don't like work, but we want to like our work. We want to do the best that we can. We want to enjoy it. Itna maza aana chahiye, itna picnic mein aate. Right? When you people go to Mumbai, people love going to Alibag. Char panch beer leke Alibag mein jaake beach kinare. Chaand ke niche. So, we want all that. And the most complex of it all, the highest of it all, is something that he called actualization. That's a little difficult to explain and I'll come to it a little later. But these are the five levels that he initially proposed. He modified them later and made it to eight levels. But we're not going to go into that. You can look it up later. Yeah, so talking about the first two physiological and safety needs. Instead of talking a lot about them, there are a few things I would like to say. Like, people don't usually always leave a company for money. It might be true if an American company comes and hires people from the WordPress ecosystem. A lot of people who start off as WordPress developers actually move into different companies. Am I allowed to say names of companies randomly? Like TCS and Infosys and that culture, Putney Brothers, etc. So these are MNCs that are actually large organizations in multiple locations, a lot of people working for them. They actually go there as well. The money difference is not much, like maybe 2,000-3,000 at times. I've seen that. No, in a month. No, yeah, per day. Per day is when you go to US. So why do people do that? Switch a job for like 2,000-3,000, leave a company and go to another company. Why? These are the words that I'm leaving you. Those are the basic needs. These are protection from elements, security, order, law, stability, freedom from fear. That's like the key thing that I feel is important here. Freedom from fear. Like somebody was saying, if you are the HR and your employee has a problem with you, who do they talk to? Is there a space where employees can go and talk about the problems they have? Something that's called a grievance redressal system. If I work in a company, and I'm not able to talk about the problems to anybody without worrying about, you know, what will happen after that. If the decisions are unilateral, if I have to face the effects of unilateral decisions, then what do I do? That's not a very happy place to be in. So Maslow also realized that, and the first 3-4 levels, he called them deficiency needs. Which means that if they are not there, there might not be physical problems, except physiologically. If you don't eat, you'll be obviously be uncomfortable. You are sick, you will be uncomfortable. But if the other needs, like freedom from fear, order in your work, etc., are not satisfied, people a lot of times become anxious and frustrated. How many people are, like, how often are you anxious and frustrated at your job? You know meaning of anxiety. Anxious, I don't mean anxious matlab thoda tension hai, thoda stress hai. Anxious matlab anxiety. Like you're worried. You're worried to death at times. Right. So that is not a natural state. Right? Even if you're the owner of the company, even if you're working as a CEO in a company, that's not a good place to be in. Do I have to point it there? I thought, the second, don't look for yourself in that picture. It is not yours. If you are in this, please meet me outside. Yeah, second basic human need is to feel loved and feel like you belong in a place. Like every day you go to a job, you spend 8-10 hours, you want to feel that, you know, this is my place, I belong here, everybody likes me. That's something that people want. But if I'm going to go in the morning and sit in my cubicle and not look at anybody else and not be bothered by what they're doing, in fact, I'm encouraged not to look at what they're doing, then I will never feel any belonging, friendship, any bonds, any love, nothing I'll feel. So that is, that also, if not satisfied, I'll be not a very happy person. So yeah, these are the keywords that I leave: friendship, intimacy, affection, love, from workbook group, because that's kind of the maximum time you spend in a day. That's the place you spend the maximum time in a day, except your bed maybe. And for a lot of people, it fluctuates. Bed come to office zyada, office come to bed zyada. Oh, sorry. Now, how do you satisfy these? Like, how do you make people feel loved and make them feel like they belong to the company? So one of the things that I said, if my voice is not heard, if I have nowhere to go, if I have a problem, ghar mein aisa nahi hota. In our families, that doesn't happen. You have a problem, you can tell your mom or your dad or eldest brother or somebody. Or mama or chacha. Like when people get married in India, the mama is the guy who gives the groom advice about, you know, what to do, etc. after the... Yeah, we have such traditions, we have such a culture. There are roles in your family, in your extended family, people that you go to when you have a certain problem. That doesn't happen in companies usually, right? So that. Second is, how much can I trust my bosses? How much do I trust my company? How honest is my company with me? Something that Shilpa talked about. I mean, everybody talked about my points, I'm very happy. So, like, if you don't feel that people don't care, if you feel that people don't care about me, they're not honest enough with me, which means people don't trust me. If my bosses don't trust me, they don't tell me the important stuff. I'm not saying everything, but the important stuff that matter to me, that affect my work, if I'm not being told that, then I'm obviously not going to feel like, you know, these guys don't trust me, they don't think I'm worth knowing this. So yeah, I don't, like, this is not a happy thing for me to do. And then the thing that we talked about when we had the panel discussion, self-esteem, the feeling of having achieved something, becoming a master of something, feeling independent, feeling like you have a status in your locality or in your industry, in your ecosystem, having some prestige, having respect for yourself and getting respect from others. All that, all of us need that, right? Sab log WordCamp isliye aate hain. Right, we'll meet some people, we'll feel, yeah, we are somebody, we belong to a community, we come for that, right? Some part of us comes for that. So how do you give people that? How do people feel important enough? Now, Maslow did this, he divided this in later further into two more levels. One was cognitive needs, like the need to know and understand and have knowledge. The second was, apart from cognitive, aesthetic needs. Thank you. Thanks. Aesthetic needs. I use a psychology student. Aesthetic needs. The need to have symmetry, form, beauty around us. Need to understand and appreciate beauty. We want all that. Sabko pasand hai na? Achha, iPhone sabko pasand hai. Why? And we talked about the iPhone. Why do you want an iPhone? Android, iPhone do the same things. Suddenly the looks. Most people want the iPhone because it has, it comes with all these factors. It satisfies our aesthetic needs, it satisfies our esteem and prestige needs. That's why we prefer an iPhone. A lot of us will say features, but I don't think that matters anymore in terms of the modern Android phones. Yeah, prestige. Prestige. Then, finally, the ultimate level is self-actualization. Now, how to explain this is, you know the meaning of the word actual, anybody? Meaning of the word actual? Real versus unreal. So I am the real Saurabh and all other Saurabhs are unreal. Any Saurabh in the audience?
I am Slim Shady,
yeah. No, but like, what is the meaning of the word actual? Actually. Hindi mein, Marathi mein? Asal mein. Asal matlab kya? Asli matlab kya? It doesn't mean real and unreal. Unique. Authentic. More words. Authentic. Truth. Any other words?
Truth.
I could. Truth. The true way. The real, real, true, actually, truly, really, such may, asli. The asli Saurabh is actual Saurabh. Everything else is just a show. Right? So, when I say self-actualization, when they say self-actualization, this is what they mean. You are somebody inside you, right? You know. सबका ऐसा रहता है नहीं नहीं अगर मेरे पास ये प्रॉब्लम नहीं होता अगर मेरा वक्त के पास पैसा रहता था तो आई वुड हैव डन दिस राइट वी हैव दिस ऑल ऑफ अस हैव दिस वी लुक एट अदर पीपल वी आर लाइक शिट यार इफ ओनली माय फादर वाज रिच आई वुड हैव या If only I got an admission into IIT, I would have done all those things that those guys are doing. If only I got into IIM, I would, you know, change the world, etc., etc. We all of us have that feeling in our head. So removing those conditions, we know who we are. At times because we need money, at times because we have a large family to support, at times because there are other needs and problems that we have. We're not able to fully actualize, not full able to realize what we overall we can do. Second thing is, how many of our developers? How many of us are developers who only do development, nothing else, ever? We only write code. Anybody? Only write code. Music nahi sunte, gaate nahi, bajate nahi, kuch nahi. No blogging, nothing, only code. Like wake up, oh, PHP tag khula hai. So, we are not that. We all know, right? There are these constraints because of which we are this way, but we want to become something else. We want to do other things. And in that sense, how do you do that? Like, if I just go back to a couple of slides. Now, we said these basic needs we satisfy by, you know, giving insurance policies, like salary accounts, that's like a basic thing. You give them disability allowances. Luckily, the government has laws now. We never had a pregnancy leave. How many people know that? It just recently happened. How many months ago was that? Days ago. Very few. We have a compulsory pregnancy leave now for a government. Huh? Not a long while. Yeah? No, it's been very recent. Now it's compulsory. 8, 10 months, 6 months, etc. Yeah, some of the laws will come from the government side, luckily, fortunately. Yeah? But generally, what happens when somebody gets pregnant with their job, to their job, in absence of such laws? I mean, nothing. So, to counter that, you need nice policies, have great benefits for employees. To satisfy the love and belonging needs, we need to have that culture where people can participate. There is this famous ad slogan, families that play together, stay together. Anybody can explain that to me? Matlab, agar roj subah aake cricket khelenge to hamesha saath mein rahenge. Huh? Somebody that? Eats together, stays together. That family is gonna be healthy. No, but what does that mean? Families that play together, stay together. What do we play? Stump form leke aate cricket khelte. Hockey stick? Nahi kya? Huh? Yeah, people who have fun together generally become fast friends. Like if families don't have fun together, if families just sit in front of TV and watch some serial every day while having dinner, otherwise don't spend time together, those families are not going to be healthy families. The same stays true for companies where employees don't have fun together, they're never going to stay together. They're going to slowly, one by one, go their separate ways to find the family that they belong to. Right? Second, I said, you know, when there is no transparency, there's no honesty, there's no trust, then obviously they'll not be happy. So companies need to have that kind of trust and transparency for their employees. Tell them things that they need to know. Tell them things that they don't need to know, but you can tell them. Anything that you can tell, the policy should be, anything that can be public should be public. Right? So that you can satisfy doing such things. How do you take care of your self-esteem needs? Like people, very obvious. We talked about in the panel. This is a problem with the WordPress ecosystem in India generally. I don't know outside. I don't know what happens there. In India, I've seen this. Most of the people who have started WordPress companies, or most of the people who are working already in the WordPress ecosystem for a while, are people who have learned this on their own. Kisi ke college mein course nahi tha. WordPress ka course kiya kisne college mein? Nahi. We might have learned PHP in college. The fortunate few must have learned some PHP and open source technology in their college. Otherwise, we don't learn these things. Everybody has learnt it by themselves. So we feel the humne seekha, to abhi jo naye aa rahe unko bhi seekh ke aana chahiye. That's our understanding, right? But think of it in the other way. Like this, the world has changed, right? It's been 4 or 5 years now. Your companies are bigger. You're making more money than you were 4 or 5 years. Some of the companies didn't even exist. So similarly, if you have changed, your level and quality and everything has changed. Similarly, your needs have changed and you need more people. You need trained people. Where are they going to come from? How many WordPress training institutes exist in India? So, if we need WordPress developers, we can't hire WordPress developers. the benefit that American companies have is all these set WordPress developers, people who have learned WordPress very well, they can hire them. They don't need that many people. So we are left with the people who probably don't know WordPress yet. How do you take care of that? Awareness and training, cool. So yeah, training basically. You can hire people who are developers, not WordPress developers, train them. Feedback? What does that mean? Or
let them know what they're good at.
See, that is one more thing. So we understand feedback as ki samne walne kaam kiya, right? Now we'll find mistakes. Understand from him how I'm teaching. Yeah, feedback is basically, it's like what is going on, you get some information about that, right? Feedback is how is this happening, what is happening, why is it happening, how is it happening? Yeah? Don't worry, this is one of my, I just have total 10 slides or something. You covered it. So we understand feedback as, jab koi bolta na, mereko feedback de. So we have our favorite national pastime is take something and criticize. That's called feedback. You didn't do this properly, you don't do that properly, this is not take, you're useless. Right? That's a standard feedback. Whereas feedback actually means something else. It's about also talking about the good things that people are doing. And also second thing we say is the schools se hamara na, we have this, our schools are the most important stage in our life. Going to school is the most important, most influential stage in life. In schools, bachpan se we are taught Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru, etc., etc. Teacher is unquestionable, etc. We have that concept in our head. The teacher is later replaced by the boss, are unquestionable. You can't question them, you can't question decisions, you can't give feedback or your own viewpoint to any decision. So feedback means both of them. Giving feedback, taking feedback, giving and taking positive and negative feedback from who? Like, take feedback and give feedback from who? Everybody. Like, there are office boys in the office who have interesting feedback for you. Right? Somebody, we must have seen Munna Bhai ka second movie and all, no? Some girl is in love with a guy and she calls up Munna Bhai for advice. And he said, look at how he behaves with the waiters. So it shows, like, hierarchy, when somebody is above us in the hierarchy, we are very nice, mild-mannered, best possible versions of ourselves. The moment we see somebody who's probably, you know, at a lower status, everything changes. So yeah, 360 degree feedback is important. And feedback. Yeah. No, I'm not worried about that. Oh, fine. Let's just slide come. Then coming back to the slide that I went back from, self-actualization. How do we do that? How do you do that? How do you help people actualize? There I feel like, at least fortunately, we are in the WordPress ecosystem. There is this thing called the WordPress community that consists of people from across organizations that has things that, you know, that you can do. For example, like all of us have to, you know, earn money. If not iPhones, we need Android phones, right? Sabko paise kamane. So clients jo kaam aa raha hum karenge. What are the clients says we'll do. At times we'll do that, especially when you're starting off or even when you're an established business. At times for the sake of money or whatever, you will take up projects that don't excite you or your developers. So what do you do then? Where do you find excitement? Yeah, contribute to WordPress. That's a lot of excitement. If not WordPress, there's a plugin that needs help. There is a theme that needs help. If not plugins or themes, there must be a jQuery plugin. There must be some open source project that requires some help and is... I don't need it. So yeah, so I am saying... So actualization means... one of the things it means is having peak experiences, having the best experience of something that I can. So if I'm programming, if I'm coding, I want to have the best experience. I want to write the best code possible that actually goes to thousands and millions of users and I can feel very proud about it. You know, my code is being used by 40,000 people. 40,000 websites run my code, or 4 million websites. How many million websites run WordPress? Million, billion? How many, what's the number of websites that run WordPress approximately? 40 million? How many WordPress contributors, code contributors here? One, two, three. Do you realize that your code reaches 40 million people? Yes, and he is very proud about it. Can we? And it's just not code. Like, think about it. You get to meet people from all around the world. You're not limited to those 10 people that work within the office, especially if your company is small. If your company has 1,000, 2,000 people, no problems. 10 people, what do you do? So yeah, then the community is a very useful tool. A lot of people say we contribute to the community because it's about giving 5% back. I'm saying give 50% back, you'll get 100% back, if that makes sense. Yeah? Or we look confused. No? So how many of you know that? There's a 5% concept. Like if you're using WordPress, you give back 5% of what you do, not in terms of money, in terms of time, in terms of effort. You give back 5% to the project. Know that? Cool, I told you a new thing. So there's this concept, if you're running a WordPress business, you give 5% back to the project or the community so that, you know, you feel not guilty. But I am saying give more and exploit the community. It's a tool. It's a feature that you can use of the whole ecosystem. The community has excellent speakers, events, has there are translation projects, there are accessibility projects, there are projects for UI, there are projects for lot of them. Just go to make.wordpress.org, you will see 7-8 things that people get involved with. So maybe at work you have to do your routine every day, wo loop mein, the content, the title, yeah. But you can go back and review other people's themes and, you know, judge them and feel good about it. So that way, that is one thing. So one is people, individuals, employees forming a company. The second is each company itself is an entity in this ecosystem, in the WordPress world. Like we've met how many companies today? We've met RTCamp, we've met 13 Llamas, we've met Ink My web, shameless plugging in, etc. We've met a lot of companies, right? So as people have needs, just like people have these five levels of needs, even organizations have needs. Even organizations, a company has a need to feel, maybe not, it's not hungry, it doesn't eat food. It doesn't need to feel safe and all. Is this working? Oh. But, like, it will be very weird if two companies keep fighting, right? If Karthik and Rahul just keep fighting all the time, oh, your company, my company is better, my company is better. I don't know what. So it would be...
Yours is better,
that's good. That's love and belong. I love you so much that I love your company more than mine. So, like, if one company exists in the ecosystem, another company exists, and if both of them show that love and belonging, the feeling of belonging to each other, you would feel like you belong in a better thing than that 9-to-5 thing that you do every day. The big picture that we talk about. It will help when the organization becomes, you know, feels loved and feels proud and feels confident and feels the prestige, feels like it's actualized, it's doing brilliant stuff, then that organization, I think, will, you know, project a better image or give a better perceived value to people, right? If you see a company that's very involved in the WordPress ecosystem, a company whose employees have been doing a lot of things in the ecosystem outside the ecosystem, if you keep meeting a company's employees at treks and you know, blog camps and WordCamps, etc., you would have a better, you will feel that this company is doing really well. This is a very good company. They do brilliant stuff. That will happen, right? I mean, if you don't agree, we can talk outside. But as of now, let's say that will happen. So if that happens, if the company becomes actualized, has better perceived value, what will automatically happen? No. Trolls. What will happen? No? केला 10 रुपए में बेच रहे हैं, राइट? बेच रहे हैं। सडनली कल को लोगों को लग रहा है केला 20 रुपए का होना चाहिए, तो क्या होगा? तो भी आप 10 में बेचोगे?
मार्केट वैल्यू बढ़ेगा।
या लाइक 15 में बेचेंगे, राइट? ऑब्वियस बात है। दैट्स वेरी ऑब्वियस। सो इफ योर वैल्यू इंक्रीजेस, यू विल बी एबल टू चार्ज मोर, यू विल बी एबल टू कमांड द रेट्स it's okay. So, I'm just saying, if we are able to command those rates, if in any other respect, we are doing the same things that, say, 10up and Automatic can, or are doing, like they come, they're very happy sharing what they do and how they do it. If we take those things and we do the same things, we are able to do the same things, we are able to show the world that we are of the same quality, we are able to actualize, you know, we're not just sweatshops that outsource projects and do it on a white label basis. If you're worried about hamara image kya hai, like Amit said in the morning, exciting projects, like we want to do projects that show, you know, what we're made up of. If you're able to do that, we're obviously able to increase our rates, right? If let's say Indian companies are charging $20 an hour now, they're not going to pay their developers $50 an hour. But doing all this, if we do all this right, in a right way, having a proper HR department, like not just for salaries and recruitment, but for other things like employee engagement and such things. If we're able to do all this, we'll be able to increase our rates. If our rates increase, then I mean, there's no reason left. If you can give people iPhones, they won't leave. Four iPhones, right? So although it sounds like an impractical, lofty ideal, but I'd like to share a small thing. Go back and find out how many people have left Automatic once they've joined. That's just a simple example I'd like to leave you with. And that's it. Thank you.